We continue our reading of From the Heart, a daily devotional by author Ellen G. White. Today's reading, February 9. Faith is the victory. I press toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. Philippians 3:14. The greatest blessing we can have is a correct knowledge of ourselves, that we may see our defects of character and by divine grace remedy them. Are we nearer to God today than we were a year ago? What a change there would be in our religious experience. What a transformation in our characters, if day by day we carried out the principle that we are not our own, but that our time and talents belong to God, and every faculty should be used to do His will and advance His glory. We may be shut in by the promises of God, which will be as a wall of fire about us. We want to know how to exercise faith. Faith is the gift of God, but the power to exercise it is ours. If faith lies dormant, it is no advantage to us, but in exercise it holds all blessings in its grasp. It is the hand by which the soul takes hold of the strength of the infinite. It is a medium by which human hearts, renewed by the grace of Christ, are made to beat in harmony with the great heart of love. Faith plants itself on the promises of God and claims them as surety that He will do just as He said He would. Jesus comes to the sinful, helpless, needy soul and says, "What things soever ye desire when ye pray, believe that ye receive them, and ye shall have them." Believe, claim the promises, and praise God that you do receive the things you have asked of Him, and when your need is greatest, you will experience His blessing and receive special help. The inquiry in many minds, in many hearts, is, "How shall I find happiness?" We are not to make it our object to live for happiness, but we shall surely find it in the path of humble obedience. Paul was happy. He affirms repeatedly that notwithstanding the sufferings, conflict, and trials that he was called to bear, he enjoyed great consolation. He says, "I am filled with comfort. I am exceeding joyful in all our tribulation." All the energies of the chiefest of the apostles were bent to a preparation for the future, immortal life, and when the time of his departure was at hand, he could exclaim in holy triumph, "I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day." Signs of the Times, May 22, 1884. This concludes our reading today of From the Heart. We must believe and not doubt.
Corners of his tattered bed that day, but if we may We'll see what these men might have had to say.
Suppose that first man said, I hate to doubt it, for Jesus touched my eyes when I was blind, and he made me see, and there's no doubt about it. But this man's needs are more serious than mine.
Suppose that second man said, no need to bother, this man's condition will remain the same. Though Jesus touched my hand when it was withered, I don't believe he can heal a man so lame.
Suppose that third man said, I hate the question, but no one here is more skeptical than me. Though Jesus cleansed me when I was a leper, this helpless man will never walk, you see.
Then every eye was turned to the fourth man to see how he might criticize and doubt. But all three men were startled with amazement when that fourth man stopped and said his name out loud.